Laplace transform is an operator which transforms a function of real variable t to a function of complex variable s. T denotes the time and s stands for frequency, which is given by Laplace of f of t is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. This transforms the function of t into the function of s. Now we will see the Laplace transform of some standard functions. Let f of t be e raised to at. Therefore, by definition 1, Laplace transform of e raised to at is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into e raised to at dt. It gives us 0 to infinity e raised to minus s minus a times t dt, which can be integrable as e raised to minus s minus a into t upon derivative of power, which is minus of s minus a. Because we are integrating with respect to t, therefore s and a are constants with respect to t. As we know, e raised to minus infinity is 0, e raised to minus upper limit value is 0, therefore 0, which is upper limit value, minus. Now lower limit t as 0, so if you put t as 0, e raised to 0 is 1, therefore 1 upon minus of s minus a. It gives us 1 upon s plus a. Therefore, Laplace transform of e raised to at is 1 upon s, this is minus, s minus a. So, in this way, the function of t is converted into function of s using Laplace transform. Similarly, if we replace a by minus a, we can prove e raised to minus at as 1 upon s plus a. This is Laplace transform of e raised to minus at. Now, let's see second function f of t is sin at. Then, Laplace transform of sin at by definition 1 is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st sin at dt. As we know, since integral e raised to at sin bt dt is equal to e raised to at upon a square plus b square a sin bt minus b cos bt. Using this formula here, if we compare with formula, we get the value of a minus s, and instead of b, here is a, so value of b is a. Let's use this formula, we get e raised to minus st upon a square, which is now s square, plus b square, which is now a square, bracket, a sin bt, but the value of a is minus s, so minus s sin bt, but b is a, so sin at minus b, that is a here, cos bt, that is cos at here. To the whole, we have integral limits 0 and infinity. Again, for e raised to minus infinity, it goes to 0, so first term for upper limit is 0 minus. Now, the entire term when t is equal to 0. So, e raised to 0 is 1 upon s square plus a square. Then, sin 0 is 0 cos 0 is 1. So this bracket uses only 0 minus a, that is minus a. So by simplifying, we get a upon a square plus a square. Therefore, Laplace of sin a t is equal to a upon a square plus a square. Similarly, we can prove Laplace of cos a t is s upon a square plus a square. So we can easily see that Laplace of t function is nothing but the function of s with a as constant here. Another function, if we consider, say f of t is constant function, say 1, then by definition Laplace transform of 1 is 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into 1 dt. It can be integrated as e raised to minus st upon the derivative of power, which is minus s with respect to t in the limits 0 and infinity. Again, for upper limit e raised to minus infinity, it is 0 minus lower limit for t is equal to 0. This is e raised to 0, which is 1 upon denominator minus s. It gives us 1 by s. Therefore, we can write Laplace of 1 is 1 by s, the another formula, which is function of s. Now, let's see function is t. Then, by definition, Laplace of t is given by e raised to minus st into t dt, which is Laplace of t. Now, Laplace of t is, here we can see this is u into v rule. So by u into v rule, generalized rule, we can have first as it is, u as it is, integral of v, which is e raised to minus st upon minus s. Then we have alternate signs. The derivative of t will be taken here as 1, and another integration of this bracket will be taken, which comes e raised to minus st upon minus s, and previous minus s gives us s square. Again we have plus, but the derivative of 1 is 0, so process is over in the limits 0 and infinity. So here what we have done, first as it is, integral of second minus derivative of first, another integral of second, plus derivative, next derivative of first. In this way, this process goes. As derivative of t is 1 and 1's derivative is 0, process is over in the limits 0 and infinity. Again, because of e raised to minus infinity and e raised to minus infinity, the entire bracket goes to 0 for upper limit. For lower limit, we put a t is equal to 0, so first term is 0 minus e raised to 0, which is 1 upon s square. So if you simplify, we get 1 by s square. Therefore, Laplace of t is 1 by s square.